started with Durham Records Office coming in and showing us different sources from around concerts, so photos, maps, marriage records, house records, so the census, and we watched a short video from, I think it was the 80s, of Consett Steelworks as well.
The part I enjoyed most was the walk around Consett because it allowed us to have a look at the place around us and learn more about the history of Consett, so like the steelworks that were around, and helped us learn more about the effect of the steelworks on the people in Consett. So like a lot of the time there was like orange dust going around, so people would be afraid to put the washing out.
We kind of learned how to use census images and maps to find where old places were, and we used photos from the present day to compare them as well.
And I think the best thing was one of the students spotting his grandparents' names on a census document, and that was, I think it brought it more to life, even more to life for them, like, oh, actually I know those people. Yeah. And amongst all these other people on this sheet, that sort of brings it to life.
The Arts Award process allowed for creative freedoms because it's a kind of safe space to voice your opinion and your view, and you don't have to toe the line there.
I think it's one of the things for me personally about creativity in schools. It opens up that freedom. It makes it about more than sort of learning targets and, you know, what you can learn. It's a chance to sort of step aside and really think about, you know, wider things, like where do we come from? What does it mean to live in Consett today?
And then being able to kind of pull all of that together for them to be like, oh wow, I've actually, it's gone from a piece of paper to, it's, you know,
it's like a
not just a piece of poetry, but kind of like the music of them speaking. So I think it's brought them on massively in terms of their self-belief and their confidence, and kind of really harness their creativity and let them kind of take some risks and kind of call some of the shots, which was really, really nice to see some of the kind of more introverted students stepping up to the mic and doing a really brilliant job. That was fair.
So the poetry, we started just kind of creating ideas for what we were going to do. Then we recorded our own performance of a poem that we created. And then using that, we made an animated piece.
It has made a difference to me because it helps us understand what my grandparents went through and makes us feel more like closer to them when they were alive, and I know the struggles they went through during their life when they had to work in the steelworks or had to work around the effects of the steelworks.
I think another big part of the project is them learning, as well as the art skills, it's learning the other skills, the team working skills, the time management skills, the communication skills. Yeah. All of this goes to make a really good project, and I think they all get something different out of it, as well as being able to create a piece of art. It was just utterly bizarre how it snowballed by just, you know, just going a little bit beyond and pushing what we thought we could offer. Just going, oh my goodness, I never thought, like, just by sending that email or making that resource, so many people could be involved beyond the Arts Award groups.
I think it's really been a very good sort of solid foundation for working with that age group in future, working at sort of bronze and silver level. I feel now that I've got sort of solid foundations, some ideas of, you know, what could be done, how it might be done, and we can move forward from there.
I think using a, you know, the collaborative approach, I would really like to use that as a model in the future. I think it's just a win-win all around.
Yeah,
and it's having that network and those partners and knowing, and if they see something that you think, oh, hang on a minute, Consett were doing something like that. Yeah, should we get back in touch and see if they're interested in an X, Y, and Z? I think it's brilliant in terms of amplifying opportunities for both staff and students to be involved in the arts.
I think working with like-minded people with crazy ideas as well, be like, hey, I had this idea, what do you think? You're like, oh, brilliant, let's make it happen. That's been really brilliant.
Yeah.
Allow it to be student-led, have those like arts ambassadors, have those groups of students where you can float those ideas and let them maybe take it forward as well, because there's a strong likelihood that they're going to have an idea that we're not potentially going to have.
Yeah, I think the collaboration is such an important part, whether it's through a partnership or actually skill sets within schools or people who know people. I just think it's great to enhance what you're doing, but I think it's also great when you need a little bit of help.
It kind of makes me want to explore more art kinds. It kind of makes me want to go into animation more. I was even thinking about starting a YouTube channel doing animation. It's just made me want to explore more arts.